Hey guys, today in Substance Designer Tips and Tricks, we're going to learn how to round the corners of a shape. I'm going to show you three ways to do it and the pros and cons of each one of them. The first way to create a round corner is by using a bevel node. We need to create two nodes, a bevel and a levels. Connect your shape as the input of the bevel, and connect the height output of the bevel as the input of the levels. The idea behind this method is to bevel the image and then recover the black and white contrast of the shape with the levels node. To achieve that, we will move the top arrows of the levels to the center. Or maybe easier, set all the leveling inputs to 0.5. Now, to control the roundness, we set the bevel distance to 0 and adjust the smoothing parameter. The only issue with this method is that the bevel node is expensive, so the performance is the worst of the three techniques. The advantage on the other side is that if you need to, you can also scale the shape with the distance parameter. The second method is by using the Blur HQ node. This one has the best performance and is the most commonly used. The general idea is the same as the one of using the bevel node. In this case, you blur the shape and then recover it by adjusting the contrast with a levels node. To use it, you need to create a Blur HQ and the levels. Connect your shape to the Blur HQ and the blur to the levels. Again, in the level node, maximize the contrast by moving the top arrows to the center or by setting the leveling parameters to 0.5. Now the blur intensity will become the roundness level. With this method, we get the same results as when we use the bevel node, but without the performance cost. The final technique is to use an edge detect. This method has a better performance than using the bevel node, but it's slower than the Blur HQ node. First, you need to create an edge detect node and a blend node. Connect your shape to the edge detect and edge detect to the blend node's background. Now connect the original shape as a blend foreground and set the blend mode to multiply. You can control the roundness with the edge roundness parameter of the edge detect node. The main reason to use this method instead of the Blur HQ or the bevel is that depending on the input, the result will be different, as you can see in this shape. Well, that's all for now in Substance Designer Tips and Tricks.
Good luck!